Hello everybody, and today we're going to learn how to search documents in Kuzzle. So let's dive in directly. I have here my Kuzzle locally running on my laptop, and I access it through console.kuzzle.io in my browser. So I'm inside, and I can see here I have a test index with a test collection. And within my test collection, I have more than 900 documents. Each document represents a fake employee with a last name, a first name, and a job title. So there's plenty of them, and let's say that I want to search all the employees that contain the word chief in their job title. So here in my admin console, I can go to the query options. I can type job in the attribute that I want to match the word chief. So I send the search request, and I can see here that now I have 47 documents. If I check them, I can see they all contain chief in their job title. So the interesting thing about this is that this is the kind of feature that you want to be able to implement when you are creating a web application or a mobile application. This is quite frequent. So let's say how this works under the hood. Let's see how the admin console is sending requests to Kuzzle to achieve this feature. So I have my postman here, and I'm already targeting the document search API endpoint, which I can access at testindex/testcollection/underscore search. I want to hit this API endpoint with the verb post, and I want to specify a header as content type application JSON, so that I can put here in the body of the request the whole search query as raw JSON content. So let's take a look at the query. I have here a JSON object with a query attribute, which contains a bool attribute, which contains a must attribute. This last must attribute is actually an array containing a set of predicates that I want to be satisfied. So the only predicate that I've put here is match phrase prefix, which basically needs that the content of a given field matches a given value. In this case, the field is job and the value is chief. So let's send a request and take a look at the response. So here in the response, I can see I have a hits attribute, which is an array of results. And each result here contains the word chief in the job title. So I think it worked pretty well. If I go to the very end of the response, I can see the total amount of documents is 47, which corresponds to the one that we made in the admin console. So everything seems to work pretty nice, except that if I count my hits here, I only have 10. Which seems weird, right? Well, this is because Kuzzle by default implements a pagination logic. So if I want to navigate through the pages of my results, I have to pay with these two query parameters in the URL, from and size. So as its name tells, size specifies the size of the result page, and from specifies the element that we want the page to start from. This value is actually an index, so by default is set to 0 because we are on the first page. If I want to go to the second page, I say from equals to 10, size equals to 10, and I have navigated to the second page. And if I want bigger pages, I can change the value of size to 20, for example, and I can see that my page is actually bigger. I have more results in it. And this is exactly the way we implemented the pagination in the admin console. We only play with these two parameters. So that's pretty nice. Let's see. Let's imagine that I want to sort my results by last name. So the only thing I have to do is add a sort attribute to my body next to query. Inside, I specify last name as the attribute name, and the value of this attribute will be either ascending or descending. Let's start with ascending. Let's get rid of the pagination logic and stick with the defaults. Let's take a look at the response. So I can see here that my results are sorted alphabetically from A to B to C, etc., etc. I can change this to descending desk, and if I send a request, I can see that my results are sorted alphabetically but starting from the end. So this is it for today. I just stop here, but we really just scratched the surface. You can learn more by taking a look at the Elasticsearch cookbook that we've written, because the query syntax here that you see is actually the Elasticsearch query syntax. It's the Elasticsearch DSL. And this is because when we send a search request to Kuzzle, it really just passes it to Elasticsearch. And this is why searches in Kuzzle are so fast. So you can take a look at the cookbook to learn more query syntax. You can see how many things you can do with Elasticsearch. It can really go crazy and fast. And if you feel confused, if you need help, you can join us on Gitter and we'll be there for you. So now it's your time to play. I hope you will have fun, and I see you on the next tutorial.